we can promote value and play therapy. So allow me to just discuss what is the field play. No? So our vision is that we envision a world where each child can play, blossom, and flourish. And it is our mission to create a culture that respects the dignity of children and nurtures their well-being through play. We want to foster the competent and ethical practice of play therapy. And lastly, we want to provide a community of support for the self-care of play therapists. So that is what Field Play is all about. And we were able to publish a book, The Magic of Play, Children Heal Through Play Therapy. So this is authored by Dr. Lourdes, otherwise known as Tita Honey Karandang. Okay, so our session intentions for this webinar is to talk about play. What is the value of play for children, and maybe not just for children, but also for adults? And perhaps, if you will allow me, if I can talk about the therapeutic value of play. Why is it that we have to promote play? Pwede bang ano na lang mag-gadget play na lang yung mga bata? Pwede na bang, you know, they just play in the backyard, tapos, you know, konting laro, konting sipa, tapos kung sinong natalo, iiyak, ay hayaan na lang natin ang mga bata. Pwede bang ganun na lang? But maybe through the empowerment of the knowledge that we can have for today, we can understand the therapeutic value of play. And in fact, we can even promote play across all ages, even across gender. And maybe briefly, we can talk developmental stages of play, that it is not limited to just preschoolers or just for children, but even for children across ages until preteens. And then maybe at the end, we can talk about how girls can play. Next slide. So let's talk about play. What is play? I don't know about how we understand play. Baka para sa atin, ano ba ang play? Parang, ano ba yon? Basta ba nagbabasketball lang ako? Play ba yon? Kailangan ba na may board games or may gadget? Is that what is called play? But I think what we have to understand that play is more than that. There is a bigger picture of what play is. Play is a natural way of being. You don't need to teach a child to play. Hindi po ba? Napansin ninyo? Iwan lang yung bata sa tabi. Bigyan lang ninyo ng lapis, bigyan lang ninyo ng kahon, bigyan lang ninyo ng chalk. Anong gagawin ng bata? The child will naturally find its way to expressing himself. And that is the natural language of children. It is to play. Play comes so naturally even before they speak, even before they learn to walk, even before they learn to write. Playing is so natural for children. Even as young as infants, napansin ho natin, no? Miss Clarissa, you were talking about it earlier. You have two children. And mapansin ninyo, even as young as infants, they will just get any toy, they will bang it. Magsha-shake lang sila, naglalaro na po yan, ang bata. Yung ina, kinukuha nila yung kanilang toe, tapos start to, you know, shake or suck their toe. They see a small brush, they'll bang it. It's a way for children to explore. So playing is not just important, as our mentor, Dr. Honey Karandang, will always emphasize. Play is essential for a child's total development of his being. Bakit natin nasasabing total development? Because when a child plays, the play engages the holistic development. And this includes physical, intellectual, social, emotional, and even psychological. Nakikita natin na pag naglalaro sila, it develops their gross motor and their fine motor skills. It develops their ability to coordinate their eye, their hand, their bodies, the movement, the balance. At the same time also, it is intellectual because it promotes for children how to do timing, how to observe, what is their strategy to play. Kung tatayo sila dito, what is going to happen? They're learning how to do critical thinking, logical thinking, and analytical thinking. It's also social. It promotes social development because they need to relate to other people. Kailangan nilang mabasa kung ano ba yung feedback ng kanilang kalaro. Yung kalaro ba nila parang natutuwa or napipikon sa kanila? Or are they able to strategize? Are they able to interact well? Pag natatalo sila, are they also able to regulate their emotions? Kasi minsan nakikita natin ang mga bata pag natatalo, napipikon. And they give up. They don't want to play already. So eventually, as they continue to play, natututo sila that, you know, pag naglalaro, you know, there will be a winner, there will be a loser. And what can we do better para manalo tayo next time? So that's where play is also very helpful when it comes to their social development. And as I said, pati yung emotional development nila. Paano nila i-handle yung pagkapanalo or pagkatalo? Or how is it that they can handle their emotions when a teammate will encourage them? Or on the other hand, a teammate will tell them, kasi natalo tayo kasi ito ginawa mo eh. So, siyempre, mapapaisip yung bata. What can I do better? Paano mananalo tayo dito? And also for them to value the play and to continue playing in spite of these setbacks. And lastly, psychological. Kasi nakikita nila na pag naglalaro sila, nagkakatuwaan, masaya sila. And pag naglalaro, kahit papano nakakalimutan nila ang problema. And of course, play is just a natural way, a child's natural way of being. So next slide. So ang sabi nga natin, no, play is the highest expression of human development, for it alone is the expression of what is in the child's soul. And in field play, we really promote play because ang play, ang nasabi nga natin, play is a child's natural way of expressing himself. Pag naglalaro ang bata, hindi mo na kailangan turuan. Kusang lumalabas yung pagiging mapaglaro ng bata. And the value of play is that when they're playing, something internal or something that is inside of them is coming out. Whereas, you know, ang natural kasi sa mundo is a lot of people like ang parents, ang teacher, you know, they're all imposing into the child the shoulds, what they have to do, ganon. Pero when children are playing, it allows them to express what is inside of them. What is inside of them is expressed out. So it includes their thoughts, their feelings, their ideas. And when this is promoted, when this is supported, this is where the therapy of play comes in because it gives them value. It promotes the value of the dignity of the child, of the wisdom of the child. Pag naglalaro ang bata, normal yon, tama yung kanilang ginagawa dahil ang paglalaro walang tama, walang mali. Pwede lang if it's an organized game, no? But when you give a child chalk and a carton, when the child is writing on the board, the child is in his moment of flow. Flow is a psychological term when the child is fully engaged in the activity. Yung kanyang five senses is fully engaged and the child is present in the activity. So when the child is very engaged, dito mo makikita na yung bata is just being himself. Child promotes the natural being of the child. And again, in play therapy, we promote authenticity in the child na pwedeng lumabas yung kanyang totoong pagkatao, ang kanyang buong pagkatao. And also, the play allows, as I said earlier, the holistic promotion of all the dimensions of the child's development. Next slide. In this slide po, I just want to inform you kung ano po yung literature that tells us that play is not just play na parang maglalaro lang, hayaan mo na ang bata or patahimikin natin ang bata, maglaro lang siya dyan. Pero the value of play, according to Jean Piaget, play is the children's means of making sense of their experience in order to make it part of themselves. Kung nakita natin, no, pag naglalaro ang bata, minsan they're playing out what is in their mind. And it allows them to make sense of that experience. Yung bang paulit-ulit yung paglalaro nila? Siguro mga magulang, napansin ninyo, bakit yung bata pag nagpapakwento sa inyo ng storybooks, bakit paulit-ulit yung bata? Ano? Halos mag-iisang daang beses na natin binabasa yung story, paulit-ulit pa rin yung bata. Natutuwa pa rin sila doon sa ending ng story or ng video. It's because it's a child's natural way of understanding how the world works. So they're trying to understand at their own pace, at with their own language, what is happening externally. So unti-unti ini-internalize nila yung mundo, yung kanilang pagkaintindi ng experiences, and then from there they will accommodate. So accommodation is a term according to Jean Piaget na pilit nilang iniintindi. Secondly, by Jerome Bruner, he says play under the control of the player gives to the child his first and the most crucial opportunity to have the courage to think, to talk, and perhaps to be. Sabi nga natin, to play allows the child's natural expression. So kung hayaan natin sila mag-play, it gives them the courage to express themselves. Nagkaroon ng experience si Dr. Honey Karandang na during in one of our play therapy sessions, she met two children who came for play therapy. And laking gulat niya because when the children came, they just sat there at hindi sila makapaglaro. Bilang magulang, magugulat tayo because, you know, to play is the most natural. But why is it that these two children cannot play? And, you know, behind that, the reason is because the children went through some trauma. And behind the trauma, they were in a frozen state. Hindi sila makapaglaro. Ako din, no, bilang magulang, pag hindi ko nakikita yung mga bata maglaro, ako mismo matatakot kasi hindi to normal. Parang kung nagkasakit sila at hindi sila makapaglaro, minsan iniisip ko na lang na sana hindi sila may sakit, no? Sana makapaglaro lang sila. And I will be happy because this is a child's natural way to be, for them to express themselves. So I really agree with what Jerome Bruner tells us, that to play allows them to be. And lastly, Erik Erikson tells us that to play allows children to make sense of the world, which is an enormous task for young children. They're constantly at risk of being overwhelmed by events and feelings, especially, eto tayo, nasa pandemic tayo. And children do not understand, lalo na yung mga mas bata, no? Hindi nila naiintindihan, ano ba ang pandemic? Ano ba ho itong COVID? Ito ba yung lumulutang ng mga alikabok? But, you know, children do not understand what is so abstract. And they can really easily be overwhelmed by things that they don't understand. But play remains an indispensable harbor for the overhauling of shattered emotions after periods of rough going in the social seas. So to play out is the most natural self-healing method that childhood affords. So I emphasize, play is the most natural self-healing. And tulad ng nasabi po ni Ma'am Celia, to engage in sports, to be more physical, to play out what is internal or what is inside them. It is self-healing because play is the highway for children to find their pace, to find their rhythm, to find their groove. Next slide. So kung ang kung nasasabi ko at nauulit ko lang po, no? Play allows children a safe psychological distance from problems and allows children to express their true thoughts and feelings in ways that are safe and non-threatening. Parang kung pag may problema, pag naglaro ang bata, dito nila makikita na parang pwede kong isantabi ang aking problema, yung mga what makes me anxious. Pag naglaro ako, mas nahahandle ko yung mga problema ko. Hindi po ba kayong mga magulang, kayong mga coach, kayong mga relatives, mga bata sa bahay, kayo rin po mismo baka na-experience ninyo pag may pinagdadaanan ho kayo. And instead of facing the problem head on, if you take a few steps back and you try to do a simple activity just for a short while. So it can be whether you go outside for a walk, maglaro lang muna kayo ng favorite game ninyo, o kaya mag-exercise ng panandali, house chores, as long as it's anything that you enjoy doing. Hindi po ba napansin ninyo? Mas napansin nyo, mas mahinahon ho kayo. Mas hindi na kayo galit na galit, mas hindi na ho kayo yung nanggigigil. It's because when we are engaged in activities or playing, it allows us, are the things that cause us to be anxious, and we are able to feel safe and not be threatened. As a therapeutic tool so that children can cope with personal difficulties and challenges. And this is what's behind Field Play. Now, it is not just playing, but there is therapy involved or behind play. Okay? So, what makes play? Ngayon naman po, what we can talk about naman is, why do we play? Why is it that children need to play? So, ito po, no? Play is a way for people to have a cathartic release of their pent-up feelings, whether it is you're sad about being judged or process what happens in the playroom to the outside world. So tulad rin ng playroom, yung sports that the PSC is trying to promote here. Kung when they're doing physical activities, like tulad ng napakita natin sa video, no, pag naglalaro ang bata, and we employ the therapeutic value of play in the spirit of play, then we will also allow them to have that momentary cathartic release of some emotion. So sabihin natin sa bata, no, kapag naiinis sila sa kapatid nila dahil napipikon sa paglaro, sabihin natin, o sige, gusto mo bang sa labas muna tayo, let's play football. Yung let's just kick the ball, tapos i-hit natin yan against the wall. Okay, let's do that 10 times. So, you know, after the 10 times na nagsisipa yung bata, nailabas na niya yung, kumbaga, pag pinagbawa, an emotion behind the child, and we allow the child to express it. Hindi natin sinasabing, bawal yan, huwag kang magalit sa kapatid mo, ano ka ba, kapatid mo yan, ate mo yan, huwag kayong mag-away, to release, to acknowledge the pain. A second one that makes play therapy healing is when children are engaged in play, there is some form of wish fulfillment. Just like in a dream, that hindi po ba kapag ang child naglalaro tulad ng blocks, you know, block building, patong-patong, sasabihin nila, dito ako yung prinsesa, tapos susuot ako ng magandang damit, ganito. And in that, their wishes, what are their dreams for themselves, it may not be a you know, again, because it is very cathartic, it makes the child feel empowered to be creative, of power. Tulad ng nasabi ko in the earlier slide, because of the wish fulfillment that they can be anyone that they wish to be, or they can do any versus always having the mentality that they are weak, that they are the victim, they are helpless, or that they are failures. In the play therapy na ginagawa namin, you know, children can enact that at first talo sila sa paglalaro, so may dalawang soldiers naglalaro, and then tuturuan niya para gumaling siya, tapos sa susunod na maglalaro mananalo na siya. So in this playing out of the activity, the child is able to magagawa siya ng paraan, so it gives children a sense of power. They're able to also be cathartic, developing their sense of competence to be hopeful, to value their abilities. Eventually, they can develop their self-worth. This is really the value, the belief that they matter, that they are important, and that they are good enough, or they are good at things. And if we continue to acknowledge, to affirm them, bigyan sila ng oras sa paglaro, naiisip nila or ballpen or yung mga lumang crayons at nagsusulat sila doon, or bigyan sila ng pinaglumaang bola, yung lumang ping pong paddle. Mama, o kaya kong maglaro ng yung ping pong na hit ko siya ng 2 times. Kahit sabihin natin 2 times lang, Pero para sa bata, ang laking bagay na noon, na-hit na niya yung ping pong 2 times versus na-hit ko yung ball ng 2 times. So, tayo bilang magulang, bilang mga coach, we are here, we can promote their self-worth by being very supportive, by being positive, to see the positive, to see the effort, to see their competency, their abilities, and, you know, to develop their sense of empowerment. Okay, next slide. Another way that play therapy is very healing and very therapeutic for children, it's because it makes the child see beyond what is, that they can go beyond and to hope and to dream. Parang pag naglalaro sila, sasabihin nila, ako naman bida. O kaya, gusto ko ako yung captain dito sa team natin. O ito gagawin natin, ha? So, you know, they're able to hope, to take in certain roles as they play. And, you know, as they play team by team, na pag nanalo sila, kahit na better, they can improve their play. And lastly, authenticity. A child can play out and express their deepest reality, feelings, thoughts, their needs and wishes, which contribute to finding their voice and their power. Hindi po ba pag we continue to promote our inner voice through play, through expressing and creating. It makes us be more in touch with my true sense of person, my authentic self. Kasi po ba, no, kanina nasabi ko, in this world, kasi ang bata is expected na sumunod at sumunod at sumunod lang. But when a child is given the space and the time to be, to play, then eventually, they will find their inner true person. Na ito ako, ito yung gusto ko. These are my thoughts and my feelings. And that includes the different forms of play, which I will talk about later. Okay? So these are what makes play truly therapeutic and the value of play. Huwag ho natin maliitin ang batang naglalaro. Kasi ang batang naglalaro ay naglalaro. And that is a child's role. Sabi ho nga ni Tom Stoppard, no? Because children grow up, we think a child's purpose is to grow up. But a child's purpose is to be a child. A child's purpose is to be a child. Hindi pa ho siya adult. Hindi pa ho siya equipped to be an adult. So hayaan ho natin ang batang maglaro, because that is what a child's natural way of being. Okay, so next slide. Dito po, pag-usapan ho natin, how can a child play across the ages? Sabi ko nga natin, you are never too young or too old to play. Siguro pwede ko kung kayong matanong ng sandali, and you don't need to answer, but you know, just take a few moments. In what way have you played in the past few days? Paano ho kayo nakapag-engage in activities? It can be physical, it can also be intellectual or cognitive. It can be psychological play. Pwede ho yun. For as long as I said, it is a way that you can be in touch with your natural self. It is something that is cathartic. It allows you to release your emotions. It allows you to be creative and allows you to be empowered. So, in what way have you played? So, my way of playing is that I go walking. I walk for an hour. That's my exercise. But also when I am playing, that is where I'm able to think freely. Na wala kong iniintindi na anong gagawin mamaya, anong lulutuin mamaya, yung mga anak ko ba, yung asawa ko ba, because I am just by myself. And that is, again, being in touch with my natural self. So that is also play. Okay, so in the next slide, we'll talk about, I will break it up into 3 stages of how the stages of children that they can play. You know? So I talk about early childhood, I'll talk about the middle childhood, and I'll talk about the preteens. So the early childhood is the stage between 5 to about 6 or 7 years old. Kasi this is the stage that they are just actively playing. Ito yung age na nanggagaling pa lang sila sa kanilang preschool o kaya nasa health center sila, daycare. So hindi muna sila masyadong involved sa academics. Yung papasok sila sa school, naglalaro, meron silang kantahan, meron silang mga worksheets, and they will listen to the teacher or the blackboard. But we can see that children, when they play, may konting pagbabago ang kanilang paglalaro because in the younger age, where they are just doing parallel play, ang tawag po natin parallel play, meaning I am doing my solitary play. I am probably, let's say, 3 or 4 years old. Yung bata, naglalaro, pero wala siyang kalaro. There can be a child beside him or her, but they are not engaged with one another. So that is what we call parallel play. But entering already the early childhood stage, they're already performing or conducting what we call associative or cooperative play because it involves interaction between playmates. And not only that, yung paglalaro nila, minsan merong what we call it's organized. Organized to play together because they need to accomplish something. Maybe to win because it is structured games or board games or meron silang project. And they need to communicate and interact with other people. So nakita natin sa video, mga pictures dito, it can be like 4 children, tapos meron silang project, gagawa sila ng kung ano man ang art project nila. In the lower picture, so merong si ate, tinuturoan niya yung dalawang nakakabatang kapatid niya, and they're doing some art painting, o kaya kahit na nasa beach lang sila at nagtatakbo, that is already associative or cooperative play because it involves playmates. Okay. So, in the next slide, ano ba ang kahalagahan ng cooperative play during the early childhood? This helps children to promote their creativity, their social skills, to regulate their emotion, and most importantly, it develops a sense of autonomy and initiative, which is the primary thrust for the early childhood stage. Kailangan din kasi nila matutunan to be autonomous and to initiate, to be a self-starter. Kasi ang paglalaro po, no, it complements the psychological development of children. And play is a good vehicle for that. Na pag naglalaro, they will come to say, kaya ko yan, gagawin ko yan. Okay? So, importante po yan, no? To develop a sense of autonomy and initiative. Kasi kung hindi po natin promote ang paglalaro nila, they will always be stuck with the mentality na hindi ko alam paano maglaro, hindi ko alam, ayoko gawin yan. Okay, next slide. Let's go to the middle childhood. So in the middle childhood, this is this age where children are already in their elementary stage, mga grade 1 to grade 6. So nung mga sa edad na 7 to about 9 or 10 years old. Kasi this is where they're engaged in social play. So mas kaya na nilang maglaro ng mga structured and in fact competitive games. So dito natin nakikita dito sa PSC where you promote competitive sports. So the children follow rules. They follow the organization, the organizational structure, games, rules, no? And this is where they can already begin to engage in hobbies. Yung bang parang napansin nila na may hilig sila sa pag-basketball or sa pag-swimming, pwede na silang mag-umpisa ng basic yoga, yung running, pwede sa, tulad sa video kanina. These are hobbies that it becomes their introduction to sports. Siyempre, hindi ba? Doon nag-umpisa na nagkaroon sila ng hilig maglaro. At dito natin napansin, because na in the earlier stage, no, na na-promote natin yung kanilang sense of autonomy and initiative. Coming from that sense of initiative, mapapansin nila na meron silang hilig in a certain sport or a certain physical exercise. So it becomes a hobby. And from that hobby, pag tuluyan natin itong i-promote at i-support, let's give them the right coaches, let's give them the right time, that right training, the right mindset, eventually they can go into sports and recreational activities. So let's focus on the activities that they can be good at, that it can build their competence. So dito sa middle childhood kasi, no, they are at the period that they are focused on education and their social skills, because again, they are in the school setting that society requires of them. Pero pwede natin i-complement ang kanilang focus sa pag-aaral with physical activities para mabalanse rin ang overall development ng bata. So next slide. So in the middle childhood, we want to develop their sense of industry. So yung bang coming from a sense of autonomy and initiative, ang susunod na stage dito is they will develop their sense of industry where they can build their sense of competence. And this is where, as I said earlier, they can develop their competence in a certain sports. It can be also some creative ways like playing. It can be in theater. It can be in some arts. It can also be in some literature. But ang dami pwedeng pasukan ng play therapy, no? But this is where middle childhood stage, dito nila nakikita kung saan sila pwedeng mag-focus. So kayo po, napapansin ba ninyo yung mga anak ninyo, especially in the middle childhood stage, are a venue to express themselves? Have you heard them say like, "Mama, gusto kong mag-try ng music"? Or baka may nasabi sila na, "Lola, gusto kong subukan na magpinta o mag-drawing." Tapos napansin ninyo, okay? So in the next slide, this is where you will see na huwag tayong mawala sa what is so innate in our culture. Dito sa Filipino culture, ito na pag kinalakihan natin po yung Filipino games. So gusto ho natin i-mention to, no? Yung paglalaro ng mga bata ng luksong tinik, piko, sungka, jump rope. Kahit na sa backyard, pwede ho silang maghanap ng space kahit na anong materyales na maglaro. Ako po, hanggang ngayon, meron kaming sungka sa bahay. Kayo po ba may sungka sa bahay? Meron ho ba? Huwag ho tayo ma... hindi ko, bilang respect po sa inyo. There are some beliefs kasi na pag may sungka sa bahay, parang merong mga pamahiin ho tayo, no? Pero kami po, I associate sungka with playing, and I remember I was very good at sungka. Lagi ho ako nananalo sa sungka. Kayo po ba? What are some games that you played in and that you have fond memories? Because you know that you enjoyed playing in the company of your family, of your playmates, and you're good at it. Okay? And so hindi lang ho Filipino games, but dito po ang thrust ng Rise Up, Shape Up ng Philippine Sports Commission. Pwede ho tayo mag-engage in running, badminton, kahit na yung simpleng laro na pagsisipa ng bola. These are already ways, simple ways to promote sports and physical activities. And then the next stage is preteens. Ito na po yung age between 10 to 13 years old. And at this stage, they're already beginning to express their personal interests and in fact, selective in activities and groups. Yung pag nagyayayaan kayong maglaro, sasabihin nila ayaw nila. Di ba? Parang sabihin mo ng magagulang, halika na, dati naglalaro naman tayo ng ganyan na. Eh, ayaw na nila. So pipilitin ba natin? Well, respective of their age, when they are already in their preteens and especially entering into their teenage years, they are already beginning to express their interests, their hobbies, and bilang magulang, sometimes we have to give them that space also. Okay. Also in the preteens, they're more able to engage in competitive sports and recreational hobbies. So ito kasi yung paraan nila para mag-hang out with their friends. O kung hindi naman, it's their solitary form of leisure. Yung parang para sa kanila lang, yung solo lang nilang activity. And it's okay for teenagers or yung mga preteens na minsan ayaw nilang sumali because there is something that is, there's a psychological development happening with them. Ano po ba yun? So in the next slide, ma-explain po natin ang sandali, no? Kasi in the preteens, so kayo pong mga magulang na merong mga anak na nasa age 10 and onwards sa mga 19, you might be wondering, bakit yung aking anak na magbibinata or magdadalaga, bakit parang hindi ko na siya kilala? Yung dating kayakap-yakap ko na kinikis-kis kong mga anak, ngayon pala sagot. Ngayon ayaw sumali sa mga family dinner namin, ayaw maglaro. Bakit ganun? Nag-iba na ba yung anak ko? What is going on? Actually, yung preteens natin is on a journey. It's a new journey. It's a psychological growth towards their self-identity. They're developing peer relations with those of similar interests kasi here's, it's a way for them to get feedback. It's a way for them to see kung sino sila, kung tinatanggap ba sila. That's why I said, no, yung sense of belongingness. It's also a way for them to understand themselves by seeing how others, tipo, pamilya ang core group nila. Pero as they enter into their teenage years, they expand their circle moving towards their friends and their peers. And so they get their affirmation, they get their the approval, the recognition from their peers. So mas nagiging malaki ang role ng kanilang mga kaibigan, more than just family. And so what is happening to them is truly for the core purpose of exploring their identity. Minsan tama, minsan miss, minsan parang nakikita mo yung anak mo, bakit kahapon nag-makeup siya, ngayon naman parang hindi nagsuklay ng buhok yung anak ko. Well, it's still part of their exploring themselves na yung mood nila, kinikilala nilang sarili nila. So, kahit na tayo bilang magulang, nasisiraan na tayo ng ulo kasi hindi natin nababasa ang ating anak. Parang, okay lang, chillax lang tayo. Parang, let's just give them the space. For as long as the boundaries, the limitations are observed, you know, yung limitations of mutual respect, obedience, our next slide. So, ang paglalaro, it's a way for all of us to internalize our experience, to discover challenges, for us to be healthy, to laugh and have fun, to work and imagine together. We learn to lead, to express and explore, to speak our ideas, to develop our inquiring mind, to speak, read, to write, to manage ourselves in the midst of going through very stressful times. Okay? So next slide. So dito po yung ating last slide, gusto ko lang i-mention ano ba ang mga paraan that girls can play. You know, it can be very misleading pag lagi natin naiisip na boys lang ba ang pwedeng mag-play sa labas ng bahay? Bakit ang girls hindi pinapayagang lumabas? At kung nakakulong sa loob ng bahay, hindi pwedeng lumabas, ibig sabihin, hindi nga makapaglaro ang mga bata. Especially if or quarantine. We can express ourselves. We can be engaged in human the arts. We can write, we can journal, we can paint, we can do some form of sculpture. Yung anak ko ngayon, no, they're doing car modeling at nagpipinta sila. So that is still a form of expressive arts. Pwede rin dance and movement. And this is where the PSC is promoting that we can engage in physical activities, competitive sports. And habang naka-quarantine tayo, we can still do that even inside the house. Pwede natin continue to refine our skills, our eye-hand coordination, our balance, our sharpness, our acuity, our skills in handling the rackets. So pwede pa rin yun, kahit na nasa garden lang tayo or kahit na nasa bahay lang, you can find ways. Yung naalala niyo po ba yung mga minute to win it? Diba? Kahit na baso at toothpick, pwede mong gawan ng paraan para maglaro and to practice your acuity. Pwede rin sa paraan ng music. So pagsasayaw. So with music, you dance. Kahit na simpleng TikTok nga, it, you know, it's a way just to keep your body active. Kasi kung, you know, if you start giving up on one, hindi malayo na isipin natin na you can slowly give up and move into detachment and you go into some inactivity already and before you know it, isolated na and alienated na yung tao. Some other forms of play therapy can be in the form of drama, theater, and other creative arts. So, yun po na. These are some ways that we can engage in play and sports activities. Tulad ng napakita sa video, it can be like some stretch, some form of stretching, yoga poses, paglalaro sa bahay, pagtatalon, jumping rope, kahit na magtatakbo lang sa labas lang ng bahay niyo, ikutin mo yung bahay ninyo, pabilisan or, you know, patagalan. But of course, make sure po na balanced ang inyong lifestyle, that you are still able to observe proper nutrition, adequate sleep, and balanced with your online classes. Okay po? So I'd like to end with this one about play. Sabi po ni Plato, you can discover more about a child in an hour of play than in a year of conversation. And so in play therapy, when a child expresses his natural way of playing, mas nakikilala natin ang bata. Kaysa pilit na pinapasalita natin ang bata na hindi naman kusa at hindi natural ang paglalaro para sa kanya. Okay? So maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat sa pakikinig po sa webinar na to, and happy playing!